statistical data, drawing pictographs. Look at the chart which shows how many farmers are planting different crops in a village. We have to make a pictograph of this data. We can choose a good symbol like a farmer to show the number of farmers. Now, look at the first entry. It is of sugarcane and we can see 90 farmers. Now, having 90 farmer pictures is not a good idea. It's too many pictures and it's difficult to count too. So, we can decide that one picture would be more than one farmer. Then, the number of pictures would be less and the pictograph will then be a sensible one. So, let's start. How many farmers should one farmer picture stand for? Look at the number of farmers that we have. The numbers are 90, 30, 90 and 60. So, looking at the numbers, I would say one farmer picture stands for 10 farmers. Now, let us decide how many pictures we need to draw for each. 90 farmers of sugarcane will have 90 divided by 10, which is 9 pictures. 30 farmers of wheat will have 30 divided by 10, which is 3 pictures. 90 farmers of vegetables will have 90 divided by 10, which is 9 pictures. 60 farmers of oil seeds will have 60 divided by 10, which is 6 pictures. We lightly write the number of images that we need. So, let's now put the images and make it a proper pictograph. We make space for the images. Then, we go on putting the images for each crop. After it's done, we erase the numbers we had written to the left. And the pictograph is ready. Let us do one more. Let us make a pictograph of the different kinds of books in a library. We have to make a pictograph of this data. We can choose a good symbol like a book to show the number of books. Now, look at the first entry. It is of storybooks and we can see 250 books. Now, having 250 book pictures is not a good idea. It's too many pictures and it's difficult to count too. So, we can decide that one picture would be more than one book. Then the number of pictures would be less and the pictograph will be a sensible one. So, let's start. How many books should one book picture stand for? Look at the number of books that we have. The numbers are 250, 200, 100, 50 and 150. So, looking at the numbers, I would say one book picture stands for 50 books. You can even do one book picture for 10 books, but that's still a lot of pictures. So, I choose 50 for this pictograph. Now, let us decide how many pictures we need to draw for each. We know we have to divide each entry by 50 now. We do that for each entry and get the number of pictures. We lightly write the number of pictures that we need on the left side. We are now ready to put the pictures in and make it a proper pictograph. We make space for the images. Then we go on putting the images for each book. After it's done, we erase the numbers we had written to the left and the pictograph is ready. Let us do one more. Let us make a pictograph of the different grains in a grocer's shop. We have to make a pictograph of this data. We can choose a good symbol like a sack to to show the number of sacks. So let's start. How many sacks should one sack picture stand for? Look at the number of sacks we have. The numbers are 40, 30, 10, 20 and 10. So, looking at the numbers, I would say one sack picture stands for 10 sacks. Now, let us decide how many pictures we need to draw for each. We know we have to divide each entry by 10 now. We do that for each entry and get the number of pictures. We lightly write the number of pictures that we need on the left side. We are now ready to put the pictures in and make it a proper pictograph. We make space for the images. Then we go on putting the images for each book. After it's done, we erase the numbers we had written to the left and the pictograph is ready. Let us do one more. Let us make a pictograph of the different hobbies that kids have. We have to make a pictograph of this data. We can choose a symbol. How many kids should one picture stand for? Look at the number of kids we have. So, looking at the numbers, I would say one picture stands for 6 kids because all these numbers are in the table of 6. Now, let us decide how many pictures we need to draw for each. We know we have to divide each entry by 6 now. We do that for each entry and get the number of pictures. We lightly write the number of pictures that we need on the left side. We are now ready to put the pictures in and make it a proper pictograph. We make space for the images. Then we go on putting the images for each hobby. After it is done, we erase the numbers we had written to the left and the pictograph is ready.